Hi friends, welcome to my channel. In today's class, let us discuss sections of solids. Here the given solid is a cone. First, let us take the given data. A cone of base diameter 50 mm. Here I did roughly cone diagram. As we know, base means this is the circular one for the cone. This diameter is 5 cm. Okay, here I will write 5 cm it is. And axis 60 mm long. Axis means height of the cone. So from center of this base, okay, I am taking this is O. And this is the apex. Okay, the distance between O and O1, it is called height of the cone, or we can call it as axis. So how much it is? 6 cm. Okay, so axis means it is the imaginary line between apex to center. So we know we are doing the axis with two big lines with a dot. Okay, after that is resting on its base, and next data is this cone is resting on its base on the HP. HP means horizontal plane. This cone base is resting on the horizontal plane. Let us take this is the horizontal plane. We are keeping the cone on this plane, horizontal plane. Full stop. It is cut by an AAP. AAP means auxiliary inclined plane. We are taking one plane, cutting plane. So this cutting plane is bisecting the axis and is inclined at 45 degrees to the HP. It is making this cutting plane is tilting 45 degrees with the horizontal plane. And also bisecting the axis. Bisecting the axis means whatever height of the axis, it is 6 cm. At the half means it is at 3 cm. This cutting plane is passing. We are taking the cutting plane like this. Okay, we are cutting this cone in this direction. And also it is tilting 45 degrees with the horizontal plane. Okay, this cutting plane is bisecting the axis as well as it is tilting 45 degrees to the horizontal plane. Now we are taking the cutting plane like this. We are removing this part. We are taking the remaining part. Okay, this is the remaining part. Now for this remaining part, we have to draw its sectional top view. From this direction we are seeing top view. How this section is looking from the top as well as and true shape of the section. We have to see how this section is looking like. We have to see the direction perpendicular to this cutting plane. Okay, we need to do top view as well as true shape of the section. Okay, for doing it, we have to do the projections of the given cone. Projections means we have to do the top view as well as we have to do the front view. Okay, if you are keeping the cone, I am taking this is the cone. This base is on the horizontal plane. From the top view, it is looking like circle. First, do whatever polygon or square or circle is coming, do that one. In the top view, we can see the circle. First, do the circle. Okay, for doing it, here do one reference line of some length. Here do one line of some length, it is called reference line, mark X and Y. Okay. Now after some gap of it, do one circle, it is the top view. So what is the diameter of the circle? 5 cm. Here initially I will do the horizontal diameter. Okay. Take this is the reference line, move the scale. Here do horizontal diameter. So how much diameter is 5 cm? On this line, take 5 cm. Mark the end points. Mark the middle point. So at 2.5, take the middle point. By using the compass, take this middle point is the center. This is the radius. Do circle here. Okay. Here, take this point is A point. This point is G point and center point is O point. This is the top view of the cone. Okay, so I have marked a horizontal diameter. It is A, one end, the next end is G, the center is O. Okay, at all these points, do the projector lines up to this XY line. Okay. Here, as we know, from the center, axis line is passing. Okay, and from these points also, do the projector lines. Projector line should be in light color. Okay, thin lines. Mark these points for doing the front view. In the top view, we are taking small letters. In the front view, we are taking small letters with dash. Here A, here A dash. Here G dash. Okay, here O dash. Okay, as we know, from the top view, it is looking like circle. And this apex and this center are coinciding here. Okay, which is the name we have given for apex? Here I am taking O1. Okay, both O1 and O should come at the same place from the top view. After that, we need to do the front view. In the front view, it is looking like triangle. We can see the entire height of the cone. How much height of the cone is? 6 centimeters. Okay, so above xy line, take 6 centimeters axis line. So from this xy line, here I will take 6 centimeters height. Mark, this is the apex end point. Do the axis line, two big lines with a dot like this. Now this apex is O1, we are giving. For front views, we are keeping dash. Okay, as we know, in the front view it is looking like triangle. Join these two points to O1 dash. So this is the front view. Here A and G, we have created the points. Okay, for creating number of points on the cone, let us divide this circle into some divisions, equal divisions. Let us divide into 12 divisions. Okay, for dividing the circle into 12 divisions, as we know, at the center angle is 360 degrees divided by, we are dividing into 12 divisions. So each division is 30 degrees. Okay, now take this as a reference, 30 degrees here. After 30, next 60, next 90, at 90 axis line is there. Next 90 plus 30 means 120, 120 plus 30 means 150, and already we did the horizontal line here. Now join all these points to the center. Mark these intersection points after A, B. Now after getting all these points, mark these top view points in the front view also. Okay, at all these points, do the projector lines. Projector lines are thin lines. Take this as a reference line. Move the scale. B and L are coming on the same projector line, and C and K are coming on the same line, and already we took the axis line here. Here E and I coming on the same line. Here next line is F and H. Mark the points B dash, L dash here in the front view. Next point is C dash, K dash. Next point is D dash, J dash, J dash. Next E dash, I dash. Next F dash, H dash. Now join all these points to apex. Now this is the final front view, this is the final top view. Okay, so after it, mark the cutting plane position. As you know, it is passing through center of the axis. Take one point which is 3 cm from this center. Okay, from here mark the middle point. So this is the middle point. At this middle point, do horizontal line of some length. Take this as the reference line. Here do the line of some length. At this point, take 45 degrees line. Mark angle here. So this is 45 degrees. Join this point to this point. It is a cutting plane direction. In this direction, take the cutting plane. As we know, cutting plane is two big lines with a dot. Like this. Take some length of the cutting plane. Mark the end points. This point is V. This point is T. End points. VT is the cutting plane of some length. Now it is cutting the cone. It is removing this part of the cone. Okay. Mark these intersection points. I am taking the initial point is 1 dash. Next point is 2 dash. This point is 3 dash. Like that, intersection points we are marking 5 dash. Now after 5 dash, this slant edge is 6 dash. and last edge is touching at 7 dash. Okay, now here after marking these points, let us take, this is the cone, so this is a cutting plane, it is cutting like this. Okay, this cutting plane is touching at the edges, end edges at 7 dash here, okay, and then 1 dash here. So on the remaining surface, if you are cutting like this, okay, here one point is touching and here also one point is touching. At the remaining points, two points are coming, okay, instead of one point. So after 7 dash, here I am marking 8 dash at 6 dash. Next point is 9 dash, 5 dash, 9 dash, 4 dash, 10 dash, like that. You continuously 8 dash, 9 dash, 10 dash, here 11 dash, here 12 dash. Okay. So at the last edges, we are giving only one point. At the remaining places, we are giving two points. Okay. Now after getting all the points, mark these points in the top view also. Okay. So from all these points, do the projector lines. Okay, as you know, projector lines are like thin lines. Okay. Take, this is a reference line. At 1 dash, do the line. Okay, where 1 dash will come on O dash, A dash. Okay. So extend this projector line from 1 dash up to OA line. Okay, mark this point is 1. Okay, here 1 dash, here 1. So do the projector line from 2 dash to 12 dash also. Take, this is the reference line. Do the projector line. Okay, so where 2 dash, 12 dash on O dash, B dash on O dash, L dash. So take this projector line up to OB. Okay, so this point I am taking 2 instead of 2 dash. One more point is there on this projector, it is 12 dash. Okay, on O dash, L dash. On OL, okay, here it is coming 12. On the same projector line, 2 and 12 are coming. Okay, now take the projector line here. Where is 3 dash, 11 dash? On which edges? O dash, C dash. On OC. Okay, on OC mark, this is 3. And on the same edge, OK edge, we are taking the 11. And OK, mark this 11. And after 3, 11, take the next point, 4 and 10. Okay, these are on the axis. We will mark at the end, 4 and 10. Take the next point, which is the next point, 5 and 9. Do the projector line. Take, this is a reference. At this point, do the projector line. Okay, where is 5? On OE. So, on OE, take this projector line, intersection point, mark this point is 5. And next point is 9. Where is 9 point? On OI. Okay, on the same projector line, on OI, mark this intersection point. It is 9. And similarly, draw at 6, 8 also projector line. So, where is 6th point? On OF. So, on OF, take this projector line. So, this is the 6th one. And at the same point, 8 is also there. Where is 8th point? On OH. Okay, on OH, take the same projector line. Mark this point is 8th point. Mark this point is 8th one. Similarly, at 7 also do the projector line. Where is 7th one? On OG. On OG, so 7th line projector line. Okay, so this point, intersection point. Take, this is 7. Okay, after getting all the points, here we have to mark this axis point. That is 4 and 10. So on the same axis line, we can't mark 4 and 10. Okay, for it, we have one process. Whatever intersection point of the cutting plane and axis will be there, this point. So here at this point, do the horizontal line up to this inclined edge. Take, this is the reference. So at this point, do the horizontal line of some length up to this projector. So take, this point is M dash. From M dash, do the projector line. As we know, projector lines are thin lines. So at M dash, do the projector line. Take, this is a reference line. So where is M dash? On O dash, G dash. okay, take this projector line up to OG. Okay, so take this intersection point is M. Okay, after getting M point, okay, take OM radius by using compass. Extend this radius up to this axis. Okay, and this side also extend this radius on the both sides of the axis. Okay, this arc is touching this axis line at two points. Okay, mark these two points here, 4-10. Here I am taking this intersection point is 4, this intersection point is 10, so that we can take 1, 2, 3, 4 points this side. Here we can take 10, 11, 12, like that. Okay, so here we have marked all the points. Join all these points, okay, with freehand curve. We will get the top view of this section. Okay, let us do by using freehand curve. So make it dark. Here this is the hashed section. For doing the hashed section, we have to take the 45 degrees line with equal distance. For getting the 45 degrees line, here I took one point, I did 45 degrees line just for taking the reference line. Okay, take this is the reference line. Here move the scale within this area, within this ellipse area, to the line 45 degrees lines with equal distance. So here we have to do the true shape of the section to see how this section is looking after cutting. Okay, for it we have to see in this direction. This direction is perpendicular to this cutting plane. So at all the points, do the lines perpendicular to this cutting plane. Okay, for doing 90 degrees line, initially take 1-, at 1-, take the perpendicular line, take 90 degrees here, join this point to this point. Okay, similarly at all the points, do the perpendicular lines up to some length. So last point is 7th-, like this. After getting all the perpendicular lines, here do the line, middle line, AG line, parallel to this. Okay, after some gap, take one line parallel to this cutting plane. Here do the line. As you know, AG line is the axis line. Do two big lines with a dot. So always remember, axis line is two big lines with one dot. Okay, mark these points, AG points, at both sides of the line. We took some length. Okay, we didn't measure here, just give one point here, A point, give this is the G point. Instead of same points, I am giving A1, G1. Okay, now here mark all these points here. Okay, how to mark all the points? Okay, mark one point, first point. Where is first point? It is on AG line. Okay, wherever it is passing 1-, line, take the intersection point with axis is 1-1. Okay, instead of 1, we are giving 1-1 here. Similarly, 2 and 12. Okay, so here from this axis line, take this distance by using compass. Take this distance, 2 and 12 are equal distance. Okay, so from this axis, AG axis, from the new axis, take 2 and 12 line. Take this point is the center. Okay, mark one point here, the another point here. Okay, mark this 2 and 12 point here. Okay, I am taking this is 2-1, this is 12-1. After marking 2 and 12, next points are 3 and 11. Okay, from this axis, take this length. Okay, this point as center by using compass. This is the radius. 3 and 11 are coming at the same distance. Okay, take the same distance, 3 and 11. So on this next line, mark one arc here and the next arc here. So this is 3-1 and this is 11-1. After 3 and 11, mark 4 and 10. Okay. So by using compass, take this is the distance radius. Okay, 4 and 10, both are at the same distance. So on 4 and 10, mark that length at both sides of the axis. So after 3, it is 4-1, here 10-1. After marking 4 and 10, mark 5 and 9. Okay, this point as center, okay, from the axis. 5 distance, okay, this distance, 5 and 9, both are coming at the same distance. So on 5 and 9, mark that length. This side one arc and this side one arc. Mark here after 4, 5-1 and then 9-1. After marking 5 and 9, take the next point 6 and 8. Okay, on the same projector line from this axis, take this gap. Okay, 6 and 8 are coming at the same distance. So on 6 and 8 line, take this point as the center. Mark one arc this side. The remaining arc this side. Okay, take this intersection point is 6-1 and this is 8-1. After marking 6-8, next point is 7th point. So 7th point is only one point on AG. Okay, so this is AG line. Wherever 7th line is coming, take that intersection point. It is 7-1. Okay, after getting all the points, join all the points by using freehand curve. So this is the true shape of this section. Okay, now here make this should be hashed one. For doing hashed section, as you know, hashed section means 45 degrees line. For taking 45 degrees line, here I took one point. At this point I took 45 degrees line, okay, by using protractor, and take this is the reference line and move the scale within this region and make 45 degrees line with the equal distance. Now this is a true shape of the section. In the shortcut form I am writing TS. This is a sectional top view. Here this is a cutting plane. So we are removing this part. The remaining part should be in dark color. And this sectional top view is also in dark color. True shape also in dark color compared to this part. Now after that mark the given dimension. Height of the cone is 60 mm. This cutting plane is tilting 45 degrees. And it is passing through the middle of the axis. Means at 30 mm. And here mark the given diameter of the base, it is 50 mm. The other sections of solids of cone and other solids, video link I will give in description box, please check it. If you like this lecture, hit the like button, subscribe my channel and share with your friends. Thank you for watching.